Well, hello there, it's Matt from Kenhub, and in this tutorial, we will do a quick overview of the cervical spine. The cervical vertebrae are the smallest vertebrae in the spinal column. There are 7 individual bones, and the 1st, 2nd, and 7th are uniquely shaped, whereas the 3rd to the 6th are similarly shaped. First, we will discuss the 3rd to 6th vertebrae, then the 1st, 2nd, and 7th. The cervical vertebrae C3 to C6 have small bodies with posterior and lateral pedicles. The short spinous processes are bifid in shape, whereas the vertebral foramina are shaped like large triangles. Within each transverse process, there is a foramen transversarium, and at the level of C6, the vertebral artery enters the corresponding foramen. The anterior tubercle and the posterior tubercle are the anterior and posterior portions of the transverse processes. The 1st cervical vertebra, C1, otherwise known as the atlas, as well as the 1st vertebrae in the spinal column. It supports the skull, which sits directly above it, and it only has an anterior arch and a posterior arch, with no body or spinous process. Laterally, large bone masses help to support the occipital condyles of the skull superiorly and balance the atlas upon the axis inferiorly. As with the other vertebrae, the foramen transversarium is located within a large transverse process. The anterior arch has a dental fovea, where the dens of the axis articulates with the atlas. The posterior arch contains a groove for the vertebral artery, as well as a posterior tubercle, which is a rudiment of the spinous process. The axis, or C2, as it is clinically called, has its odontoid process, or dens, located on its superior surface. It has a large bifid spinous process, and in contrast to C1, a small transverse process which houses its foramen transversarium. Lastly, C7, which is also called the vertebra prominens, is the only cervical vertebra whose spinous process is not bifid. It is called the most prominent vertebra because its long spinous process protrudes from under the skin and is visible to the naked eye. It has a large transverse process like the atlas, which also holds the foramen transversarium that encapsulates the vertebral veins and occasionally the vertebral arteries. This video is more fun than reading a textbook, right? If you want more videos, interactive quizzes, articles, and an atlas of human anatomy, click on the Take Me to Kenhub button. It is time to say goodbye to your old textbooks and say hello to your new anatomy learning partner, Kenhub. See you there!